Something I really enjoy looking at and photographing is, of course, great design. Car design, fashion, architecture, they all somehow relate in some ways together, you know, it mingles as one.
Go on.
Hi, my name's Anton Watts. We're here at my home and it's called the Walk Street House. The thing I find really cool about it is that when I return from a project, I come back here to this little oasis and it feels like I'm on vacation. One of the other things I love about this house is all the different areas we can go to outside. We're lucky we have a roof deck, so we have a view of the ocean. We love to hang out on the Walk Street deck because we can play ping pong, and it's a brilliant place for the kids because they can be out on the Walk Street. My daughter, she's out on the street roller skating. A lot of the kids around here surf, so my son surfs pretty much every other day. It's good for the kids for sure, and good for us. We really wanted to have a welcoming and cozy vibe for the house. With the amount of glass that's in here, you know, I'm constantly like, oh, look at the light. It's never ending, the light coming in on different angles, and I'm kind of looking at that, telling my wife, oh wow, that looks cool. Most people think I'm probably a bit mad because I'm excited by light, but that is my job anyway. So the fact that we have such great light in here, it makes you feel good, you know?
I'm Robert Sweet. I'm the founder and principal at Rasa Studio. We designed and built the Walk Street House. When Anton and Marty came to me, their brief was pretty simple. They wanted a house that connected to the outdoors. We have a 26-foot wide slider that pockets out of sight, really blurs the interior and the outdoors, allowing the house to live larger than its square footage would do so.
And we use this area so much, and the doors are open all the time. It's amazing. Robert made some really smart decisions about storage for the house.
So with the small footprint, we wanted to maximize efficiencies. There's a lot of built-ins that provide storage throughout the house, and they kind of replace furniture. You know, designing and building with sustainability in mind, it benefits everyone. A passive design was used to provide the cooling for the house. It's the use of operable windows, sliding doors, and skylights keeps the house cool using the ocean breeze. Radiant floor heating provides the heat for the house. It's hydronic. Western red cedar is used throughout both the exterior and interior. It's responsibly forested. The use of natural light, open floor plans, the use of honest materials, all those things contribute to, you know, good modern design.
And when we were in the design phase of the house, we were like, okay, Robert, we need to fit a piano in because it's my father's grand piano. I grew up with him teaching me how to play at the age of 5 on that piano. And it's a family heirloom, obviously, but it has a lot of memories, and dad'd love where it is.
Well, we wanted the living spaces to be on the ground floor. And one of the city requirements was to provide a 2-car parking garage. And instead of having those horizontally, we thought, why not stack them vertically and use a mechanical lift, minimizing the footprint of the garage. But we did want to have a little fun and introduce some natural light. And so we placed a picture window at the top of the lift, which frames the vehicle from the outside.
I've always loved cars since I was a kid. I've been shooting cars for almost 20 years now. When I'm shooting cars, I'm always looking at where the light's going to be and how we can kind of use that light to emphasize the character lines of the car and so forth, but at the same time, create atmosphere and energy. And that can be done in a lot of ways. In the case with the Genesis on the dry lake bed, we had a lot of dust kicking up and backlight, so that really gave it some atmosphere.